first explosion blew out the top part of a reactor containment building at the Fukushima No. 1 nuclear power plant. This footage inside the building was taken during a regular inspection. The nuclear reactor is housed behind this robust wall. This is what a nuclear reactor looks like. The uranium inside the fuel rod inside the reactor undergoes nuclear fission. The rods emit heat, generating energy. Usually water cools them to maintain their temperature at 270 degrees Celsius. But if the cooling fails, the temperature could rise to over 1200 degrees. This temperature is hot enough to melt the fuel rods. When the earthquake hit, the first safety system to prevent a meltdown was activated. Control rods rose into the reactor to stop the nuclear fission. As planned, the reactor stopped operating. But the fuel rods were still hot. Water should have been circulated to cool them down. However, this didn't happen because of a power outage right after the quake. So the second safety system turned on. The emergency diesel power generator began spraying the rods with coolant. But an hour later, something unexpected happened. Without warning, the emergency generator stopped. Around this time, the tsunami, possibly as high as 10 meters, hit the power plant. Experts think this is what caused the generator to fail. Now, the third safety system started operating. It converts steam traveling through the pipes into water. It cools the rods, but the water level went down and the temperature continued to rise. All three safety measures had failed. Professor Akira Omoto of the Japan Atomic Energy Commission was involved in construction of the Fukushima plants. He thinks the cooling water somehow leaked from the reactor.
The reactor's coolants must have leaked somewhere in the building. We thought we had taken adequate precautions for a tsunami, but what happened was beyond our expectations.
To forcibly cool the reactor, seawater had to be pumped into it and the containment vessel. Similar failures and a huge explosion also hit another reactor at the plant on Monday. Once again, nature has challenged man's best efforts.
Until next earth-changing global catastrophe occurs, Fukushima Daiichi Nuclear Reactor Containment Breach Power Plant Meltdown Chain Reaction Disaster Event remains gravest earthbound threat facing humanity. Daiichi Power Plant Radiological Threat Constituency Summary comprises following elements. 1. Reactor core containment loss mitigation involving three separate complete core meltdowns. 2. Special hazard attention focus, reactor number 3 possessing MOX plutonium content. 3. Localized site instability threatening adjacent reactor complex, DANI, utilizing four reactor core units with subsequent fuel rod storage pools and common storage concentration area. 4. Severe structural integrity situation involving reactor 4 spent fuel pool. 5. Additional spent fuel pool considerations for all subsequent reactor housing structures. 6. Common wet storage fuel pool containment stability for housing all newly migrated spent fuel pools. 7. Secondary fuel storage site stability, dry cask encasement storage permanence. 8. Continued salt water corrosion compromising zirconium cladding surrounding fuel rods. 9. Continued salt water contamination threatening Pacific Ocean viability. 10. Salt water filtration element containment, large heavily contaminated mineral filter storage. 11. Ongoing radiological nucleotide saturation eviscerating Japanese genetic heritage, risking nation and culture. 12. Continuing risk potentiality possible extinction level event scenario escalation. Fuel storage pool reactor 4, compromised building integrity continues against reinforcement efforts, fuel rod sequestration process scheduled beginning March 2014. Comprising of 6 separate nuclear reactors, Fukushima Daiichi plant complex utilizes 2 storage methods for housing spent fuel rods. Containment Zone 1 uses common wet pool design, already containing well over 1,000 tons spent fuel. TEPCO plans migrating spent fuel pools for all 6 reactors to common pool storage. Reactors 1 through 6 contain nearly 100 tons waste each. Reactor 4 houses over twice this amount. Unit 3, Unit 4, their spent fuel pools contain especially hazardous MOX plutonium-type materials. Unit 3, having suffered terminal coolant loss, has melted down. Speculation only assumes corium location. Exposed Reactor 3 corium contaminant with unique MOX plutonium signature detected in adjacent turbine rooms for Reactors 2 and 3, indicating exposed corium as molten mass on basement floor. Second storage type, beyond common pool storage, Daiichi Power Plant also houses dry cask type storage using corrosion-resistant cladding dry containment vessels within housing structure, less vulnerable to failure than wet storage pools. TEPCO idealistically hopes converting newly migrated wet pool content into dry cask storage. However, this process will take well over a decade to complete. Idealistic conditions cannot be assumed for seismically volatile region that Japan is. Additionally, global perturbations caused by changing planetary influences, political, social, economic and meteorological instability only increase inevitable dilemma probability.
TEPCO continues unabated committing crimes against humanity, inflicting simultaneous suicidal global nucleotide radiological devastation. Domestically, expectation cannot be foisted upon Japanese ingenuity alone during inevitable multiple nuclear reactor power plant failure pending unforeseen exotic circumstances. Citizens living within Nihon, their majority public consensus opposes nuclear power strongly. Average people dislike using nuclear power. Bribery, extortion, threats, manipulation, harassment, promises, forfeiture and costly judicial litigation, these methods amongst many more. Hitachi, TEPCO, GE, Toshiba, Westinghouse. Corporations use pathological predatory persistence, employing any feasible possibility within grasp to control people, ultimately gaining power, subduing opposition, obtaining maximum profit, most important of all, destroying community and environment.
ないんですか？ないんですか？あの、政府としてですね、そのできる限り被爆を少なくしていくという取り組みはしております。答えになってません。答えてください。つまり、答えになってないです。ないということですか？あるのかないのかどっち？
福島県は県民は権利があるかないかは私は分かりません。ああ、おかしいでしょ。じゃあ、あんたにはないの？あんた自分で権利ないと思う？なあ、健康に生きる権利ないのか？言ってみろ。福島県民は人権がないんですか？福島県民だけ公衆衛生上の被曝で基準が違う可能性があるという意味ですか？
今のお話だとそういうことになっちゃう。そうですよね。申し上げているのは、申し上げる限り被爆を少なくするという取り組みを行っている。答えになってないね。福島県民だけが違う基準だってことじゃないでしょ。私がお答えできるのはここまでです。はぁ？誰ですか、これは。避難したい人は避難していい。当たり前のことを当たり前に認めてください。お願いします。
あなたが一言だけでも結構です。ご回答ください。今答えられる範囲で結構ですから、一言だけでも結構です。ご回答ください。避難されるのは地方の判断に基督としては安全な地域については強制することなくですね、止まっていただくことを。
福島市は安全なんですね。緊急事態でしょ、今。福島市は安全なんですか、この緊急時。どこが安全なんですか。どういう挙げ方で安全なんですか。あのね、共産圏のチェルノブイリ、ベラルーシでさえ、どんどん避難させたんです。
ですよ。
そうだ、
この国はコミュニティによるとですよ、
旧ソ連でさえやったんですよ。
2週間で24万人の子供と避難させたんだよ。
そうだ、
4ヶ月経って何やってるんですか。
政府をここに来て
恥ずかしくないのか。
何のために来てんですか。
あ、ございます。で、中でも尿路検査については早急に調査をお願いしたいと思います。誰がどのように調査をするのかことについてご回答いただきたいと思います。
ご説明ください。
持ってきなよ。
そうです、これが証拠なんですよ。ふざけないでくださいよ。もう
コメントしたこと、
逃げないでくださいよ。
報道しますからね、こういうことね。
あ、ちゃんと持ってきなさい。
ちょっとね、これいいじゃないかい。
持っててもらえません。
何でも違うのか、コメントください
。ね、お願いします。
署名用紙を持って今持っていこうとしませんでしたね。その理由を教えてください。
持っててください。
あなたの首にかかりますよ。これ中央政府に出しますから、あなたの首にかかりますよ。弁解しないとあなた首になりますよ。
持ってってください。ね、尿持ってくぐらいいいじゃないですか。
食性が違うんだよ、ね、ちょっとだから一言でもない
じゃないですか。渡していただきたいですよ。
いや、もう食性が全然違うんですよ。食性どう違うんですか。
いや持ってくべきじゃないんですか。せっかく持ってきた約束を守って持ってきたんだから、
せっかく持ってきてくださったんだから。なんであ
なたたち前、ね、尿持ってきたら検査するって言ったんでしょ。違います。
ちょっとほら持ってってください。もうダメ逃げちゃダメ。ここで逃げちゃダメですよ。人間として付き合ってください、我々と。ねえ、どこを見てんですか、皆さん。霞ヶ関が大事なんですか、それとも福島の人が大事なんですか。ねえ、ねえ、ほんと。ちょっと頼みますよ。
現地対策法なんで、現地法の現地対策法なんで、ちょっと職業違うんです
か。ちょっと、どうしてなんですか。ねえ、あなた、お子さんいないんですか。
All day we have heard the reassurances that the radiation now being found in some of the U.S. milk supply is minimal and poses no risk. So we spent this day answering some serious questions. Since the radiation in some form has been found in 20 states, exactly how much has been linked to the milk and how are the experts sure that it's safe? ABC's Abby Boudreau is at a lab in San Bernardino, California tonight. Abby.
Diane, with radiation still leaking from the reactors in Japan, tonight, here in California, there's growing concern about how that radiation is impacting our milk supply.
This is the National Air and Radiation Environmental Laboratory in Montgomery, Alabama. This lab is the front line of defense, where the government's been working around the clock to track radiation levels in milk produced all over the United States. That fresh milk could end up on your table within a few days. The levels of radioactive iodine detected in milk in Washington and California so far are minuscule. The government says 5,000 times lower than what the FDA considers a public health concern. And iodine breaks down quickly. Even if a quart of milk in your refrigerator contained trace amounts, it would deplete by half in just